Positioning is one of the key concepts in CSS that you need to understand thoroughly if you want to be in complete control of your layouts. In this crash course, you will learn everything you need to know about it, from position static, relative, absolute, fixed, and sticky, to feel comfortable and confident when positioning elements in CSS. Alright, I have a simple demo on the CodePen so I can show you exactly how position property in CSS works. HTML is straightforward. We have a container. This is this element right here, and a number of elements within it, h1, title, that contains this text container, and a number of elements, and elements are designated with classes element 1 to element 5. Very straightforward. CSS, straightforward as well. We have a little bit of styling applied here. The thing that I want you to pay attention here is this minimum block size property on the body tag. It's set to 200 viewport block, and the only function of this is to give us scroll bar on our page. So I can scroll up and down on the page, and you'll see exactly why we need this in a bit. Everything else is pretty much irrelevant for this particular demo. We will work with elements designated with element class, and I have a little bit of styling applied to those elements, but nothing that really affects positioning. We will work with the position property, and position property defines how element behaves within the normal flow of the document. And the normal flow of the document is exactly what you see on the page here. It's defined in HTML. We have a container, and within that container, there is a number of elements, and those are laid out as you see, one within another or one under another. And we can actually tweak how they behave by using position property. So let's try it out. So we'll tweak this class element active and change it to element 2. By default, position on this element is defined as static. You can verify this if you open developer tools, select this element. I will open developer tools in inspect mode. If you want to learn more about developer tools, I have a number of guides here on my channel. So check those out. Link to one of those should be on the screen right now. In any case, I've opened developer tools in inspect mode, and I'll select this element number 2. And if I go into the computer tab here, I'll move this a little bit upwards, and I will search position property. I will enable show all properties because I want to show properties that have default browser values. And as you see, this element has position value set to static. This is what all elements have by default. Position static effectively means that this element is within the normal flow of the document. There are two things that you need to know about elements that have position property set to static, which are basically all elements when you add them to the page, unless you tweak their position property. The first thing is that the properties top, left, bottom, and right, and their equivalent logical properties, will not have any effect if you apply them. And the second thing is the z-index property will also not have any effect. Let's try this out. We know that this element has position static. I will close developer tools, Command-Shift-I, and I will set here top property. Let's try 2 rem units. And actually, I shouldn't be using top property. I should be using inset block star property, which is a logical CSS property equivalent to top. If you want to learn more about logical CSS properties, I have an in-depth guide. Link should be on the screen right now. Inset block start. 2 rem units, and as you see, this has absolutely no effect on our element right here. It's exactly in the place where it was before. The second value you can apply to position property is relative. I will comment out of this line of code right now, and I will apply position relative here. As you can see, absolutely nothing changes right now. Element is still behaving as it was behaving before. The only real difference here is that this element can now be offset from its current position by using properties top, left, bottom, and right, or their logical equivalents, inset block start, inset block end, inset inline start, inset inline end, and you will be able to change the Z order of this particular element. So let's try enabling this property, inset block start, 2 rem units. As you see, element now has moved, and it's actually overlapping our element number 3. Let's actually increase this to 3 rem units. And let's add another property here, inset inline start. In this particular case, left or right document mode, this is equivalent to left property. Let's also set it to 3 rem units. You will see that this element is nudged from its default position, but it's still occupying exactly the same space in the flow of the document as before applying those properties, inset block start, inset inline start. The only difference is that this element is painted elsewhere, but the flow of the document remains unchanged. And just as well, the index property will now work on this relatively positioned element. I will not dig too much into seeing this property. It's a pretty complicated subject. We should probably do this in another video. If you want to learn more about that, let me know in the comments and I'll probably create another video that addresses Z index and exactly how it works in detail. But until then, let's return to our position property. And the next position value that I want to talk about is position absolute. Before we change our position to absolute, let's comment out inset block start and inset inline start. And now let's change our position to value absolute. Now something happened. And the main thing that happened is we have removed our element 2 from the normal document flow. Element number 1 is exactly in a place where it was. We are not changing that. Element number 2 is out of the flow of the document, so element 3 will actually fall into its place, and element 4 and 5 are again in the normal flow of the document, so they will be as expected one after another. Absolute value for position also allows you to use top, bottom, left, and right properties, or inset block start, inset inline start, inset inline end, inset block end properties, and I will enable them so you can see exactly that they do work. But the curious thing that happens right now is, as you see, this element is no longer moved from the position where it was, but actually it is moved 3 rem units from the top of the page and 3 rem units from left of the page. If I change those values to 0, you're going to see that our element will be exactly at the top left of the page currently. This doesn't mean that element with position absolute is positioned absolutely on the page. It means that it's positioned absolutely relative to its parent container that has a position set to anything other than static. Essentially, we don't have any positioned elements on this page. This means that this element will be positioned absolutely on the page itself. If I roll the browser, you're going to see that it moves away. It's exactly at the top left of the page. But if any of its parent containers would have position set to anything other than static, which is the default, as you know by now, then this would change. So if we set our container to position relative, you will see that this element, element number 2, is now positioned relatively to that particular element. Element number 2 is a child of a container, and as container has position relative, this means that position absolute here will be defined in context of this particular container that has position relative set. You can tweak this, of course, any way you want. You can set this to 2 rem unit as we had before, and maybe you can set an inline start to minus 2 rem unit, and you'll see exactly how it works. This element is notched in the container that we set for it by setting position relative. So the crucial thing to know about position absolute is that element that is positioned absolutely will be positioned in the context of its closest parent that has position set to anything other than static. If there are no parent elements that have position set, this means that it will be positioned exactly on the page itself. Another thing that I want to mention here is that this element, even though it's out of the flow of the document, will be affected by a margin property. So if you set margin on this particular element, element 2, you will see that this element will be notched again. Let's set margin block start to 2 rem units. And as you see, element has moved. And if we set inset block start to 0, you're going to see that element will not be exactly at the top of our container. It will be notched 2 rem units down because we have margin block start set to 2 rem units. This is just something to keep in mind. If you're working with position absolute, elements will still respect their own margins. I will comment out margin block start and I will reset inset inline start to 0 as well. The next value for position property is position fixed. So let's apply it. The elements that have position set to fixed behave very similarly to elements with position absolute, but the crucial difference is that position fixed means that element will be positioned in relation to the visible part of the viewport. As you see, when we applied position fixed here, our element moved exactly to the top left of our page, even though we have position relative set on the container. And the thing to note here is that if you scroll the page, the element will stay exactly in the place where it was, because it is positioned according to viewport and not according to page. If this element was positioned absolutely, let's change it, and let's comment out our container, it now behaves similarly to position fixed, but when you scroll the page, the element will scroll with it, because it's not positioned according to viewport, but it's positioned according to page. So that is the key difference between position absolute and position fixed. And the last position value I want to show you is position sticky. And this is a really nice one. Let's change it. So what happens here is we have an element exactly in a place where it was before in the normal flow of the document. Because position sticky is a little bit of a mixture between position relative and position fixed. In order for position sticky to work, you need to have one of the top, left, bottom, or right properties, or their equivalent logical properties defined. If you don't have that, position sticky will behave exactly as position relative. But the difference between position relative and position sticky is that when you scroll the page, when this element, or element 2 in this example, comes to the top of the page, it will behave as element that has position fixed set. But as you see, not on a page itself, only within the context of parent container that has basically display value set to block. As our container is a div element, by default is going to have display value set to block, and that's why this sticky element here is sticky within that particular container. So at first, when it's rendered, it will behave as relatively positioned element, but when you start scrolling, if this element goes outside of the boundaries of the viewport, it will behave as a fixed element, as element with position fixed set, but only until the end of its container, rather right around here, at which point it will go away from the viewport. To demonstrate how this works exactly, I will change the display property on the container to inline. And this will mess up this layout, but that's not really relevant here. What I want to show you is now if you scroll, you're going to be able to scroll all the way down on the page, and this element will behave as a fixed element on the page itself because it doesn't have any parent containers that have display value set to block. Or its containing block now becomes effectively the page itself and not one of the parent elements we've added to the page like we have here, the container element. And basically this is everything you need to know about positioning in CSS. To recap, by default, all elements on the page are positioned statically. They have position static defined by default by the browser, and they will be within the normal flow of the document. Then you have position relative, in which case element will still be within the normal flow of the document, but you can nudge it in top, bottom, left, or right directions. Of course, use logical properties. And you can tweak its Z index value as well. Next value we have is position absolute, and position absolute element will be positioned in the context of its closest parent that has position value set to anything other than static. So if you don't have any parent elements that have position set to anything other than static, it will be placed in the context of the page itself. But if one of its parents has position value set to anything other than static, it can be relative like we've shown in this demo, but it will also respect position absolute, then this element will be positioned in the context of this particular parent container. Next, we have position fixed, which behaves very similarly to position absolute, but it's always in the context of the viewport, not in the context of the page, because as you scroll the page, this element will stay exactly in the viewport position where you put it. And lastly, we have position static, which is a hybrid positioning between position relative and position fixed. Element is behaving as position relative. It is within the normal flow of the document, unlike when we're dealing with position absolute and position fixed. But once you scroll past its top, this element will move along with the screen until the boundary of its container, which has display set to block. So if it's within the container that has display value set to block, which are all div elements by default, then it will stop scrolling with the page when it reaches the end of that particular container. If you made it this far, please take 1 second and hit that subscribe button if you still haven't. It would be a really good signal for me that you want to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different position. Or rather, in the next video.